Hello learners, today we will discuss about significance of lesson planning. We start with definition of Harry Wong. According to him, the greater the structure of a lesson and the more precise the directions on what is to be accomplished, the higher the achievement rate. According to Jean Tomer, he defines a teacher as is one who brings us tools and enables us to use them. It means a teacher helps us in every field and gives us tools that enables us to use them. Five main things which a teacher can do for his or her students. First one is care. Second, set high expectations. Third one is create orderly, structured classroom. Fourth, earn respect, stay calm, exercise, and self-control. A teacher can treat each student with courtesy and respect. Now we discuss about what is a plan. A plan is typically a list of steps with timings and resources used to achieve an objective to do something. It is commonly understood as a temporal set of intended actions through which one expects to achieve a goal. If we plan something, then it helps us in every field. In our class, we should enable to answer each and every question of student. And why is it important to plan? Why we plan? Because planning helps you to reduce uncertainty or panic and gives you confidence and clarity. Second one is it reminds you to prepare materials beforehand and makes it easier for you to organize the time and activity flow in the classes. It suggests professionalism and commitment. For students, evidence of a plan shows them the teacher has devoted time to thinking about the class. It means when a teacher delivers his lecture with planning, it shows that he has saved his time on evidence of a plan. It is a way to help gain the respect of your students. Planning ensures that the class you are teaching gets a balanced mixture of different materials, content, and interaction types. Planning helps you to develop a personal style. When we plan a lesson, then we can deliver our lesson in our own personal style. Now, we discuss about what is a lesson plan. A lesson plan is a guide which helps execute a mission that is to be accomplished in the classroom with the children. When we discuss about our plan or we make our plan, we think about the things, what I am teaching, how will I teach, and why I am teaching. A lesson plan can also be defined as a creative process which provides a framework for the purposeful learning. It's the framework for the lesson. It is the map to follow during class. Before we plan everything, we think about our class, and lesson plan is the map to follow during class. It is the product of thoughts about the class to give and what is hoped to achieve. Why we lesson planning? Research has shown that student learning is correlated to teacher planning. One major explanation is that when a plan is ready, teacher can focus on its implementation. It means when there is a plan in the hands of teacher, then teacher easily focus on its implementations. When teacher do not have to think so much about what they need to do next, they are able to focus on other parts of the lesson. It means when we have plan in our hands, the teacher easily focus on their topic, on their subject matters. In short, we can say that when a plan is prepared, the teacher's cognitive load is less and they can pay more attention to other aspects of learning process. By this, we can enhance our learning of the students. Lesson plan comfortably aligns classrooms, instructions with the curriculum, goals and objectives. Lesson plan also shapes how and what students makes. This helps influence positive attitudes of students toward learning. Lesson plan serves as a checklist that guides teacher to be systematic in the delivery of their lessons. Lesson plan serves as a historical document of what the teacher did in the class. The teacher is able to look back, reorganize and update his lesson future usage. Now we come on the topic significance of having lesson planning. First of all, we discuss a planned lesson is just better. Not all planned lessons are fabulous and not all unplanned lessons are a disaster. But even a bad lessons will be less bad plan. And even a great lesson can be greater with a plan. If you are good at teaching unplanned lessons, you will be even better at teaching with a plan. It means if we plan a lesson, we can deliver it very easily and very effectively. There are several reasons why a planned lesson is better. One of them is that having a lesson plan helps you to maintain focus. If we have lesson plan in our hand, then we can easily focus on that main content. With a classroom full of children, with their short attention spans and their natural desire to disrupt anything and everything, it is very easy for a lesson to be sidetracked or derailed completely. And the best way for you, the teacher, to steer the lesson back on course. A lesson plan keeps you on track and keeps the kids on track, but it also helps outside the context of the lesson itself. Lesson planning lets you track progress and problems. With planning, we can track problems and progress also. With planned lessons, you have the actual paperwork of everything you have taught, so you can refer back to it later. It means when we have lesson plan in our hand, we have the actual paperwork of everything and we can refer again it back if needed. Each lesson plan sets a discrete achievable goal teaching and the for target language for the lesson that you can aim for the during the presentation phases and judge the success of during the production phases of the lesson. This fits in perfectly with the framework of creating discrete tasks, tracking accomplishment and celebrating small wins. Now we discuss about great teaching starts with great planning. If we have plan our lesson good, then it shows its effect in great teaching. What are the characteristics of a great lesson plan? We discuss about this. Firstly, it has clear instructions, explanation, timelines, expectations and assessments. interactive, it is interactive, hands-on activities, because we have a plan in our hands and we can choose easily the topics on which interaction can be done. Engaging and fun, we can engage the students in their work and they also create fun. Allow students to feel a sense of shared exploration and discovery. Give student choices. We can give the students about their choices, about their needs, and they can do their work according to their needs and their interests. And good planning also helps us to keep on us track, keeps the teacher and students on track, achieves the objectives, helps teacher to avoid unpleasant surprises, provides the roadmap and visuals in a logical sequence, provides directions to a substitute, encourage reflections, refinements, and improvement. Lesson plan also enhances students' achievement. If we do not have a plan in our hands of our lesson, then what are its significance? Poor planning, when our planning is not good, we will discuss about this. Frustration for the teacher and the students. It creates frustration on both the parts, for the teacher and also for the students. Aimless wandering, no connection to prior learnings, deorganizations, lack of needed materials, a waste of time, poor management. Now we discuss about instructional planning and strategies. What are our instructional plannings and strategies when we plan a lesson? When we start a lesson in the class, what we have planned about? These are plans are developed to provide students with meaningful learning experience. Second one is plans connect to relate learning opportunities. Teaching is a based instructional strategies that focus on best practice and research. Teaching is supported by strategies that foster interest and progress. General policies. What are general policies while making a lesson plan? Plans are a legal documents, usually required weekly to the supervisor. Plan books, districts purchase self-made notebooks. And last one is must include in our policies, we must include stacks, bell ringers, objectives, procedures, needed material, and closing. Now we discuss about how should I structure my lesson. When we are going to prepare a lesson plan, the steps mainly what we think that we keep in our mind. That is, the structure of a lesson plan will not be exactly the same every time you plan, but instead you will vary according to multiple factors. And these factors include the age and ability of the students, the time of the day, the duration of the class, the gender distribution in the class or group interest in the subject, where the lesson falls in the larger unit. Break assignments into small chunks, hands-on manipulatives, ask open-ended questions, make lesson relevant, allow students to develop own questions to research, integrate diverse teaching strategies, talk at appropriate level. Now we discuss about a good lesson plan includes what are the main points which should be included in a good lesson plan. First one is text, second objective, expected to student behavior. We set our objectives according to the behavior students. Warm up and introductions, procedures, materials. In material we should see about worksheets, films, texts, etc. And mainly focus on presentation, how we present our lesson. Practice, application, closure, evaluation. In evaluation, we should include test, assignment, teacher observation, etc. Let's begin how we should make our lesson plan. The format of a lesson plan should be go one step at a time. When we should make a lesson plan, we discuss step by step and we should go one step at a time. Have a picture of every step. It means in our mind, we have a clear picture of every step. An effective lesson plan is a set of plans for building some things. It constructs the learning because a good lesson plan constructs learning. What are the objectives of lesson plan? What are we think in our mind when we plan a lesson? A description of what the students will be able to do at the end of the lesson. Provides alignments with district and state goals. Use behavioral verbs to describe the expected outcomes, that is action. Know, knows, appreciate, enjoy, love, etc. What are the materials in lesson plan? Plan, prepare, have a on hand. This is Murphy Law. He says that plan, prepare, and have on hand on everything. Envision your needs, list all resources, have enough alternatives when needed for groups or individuals. Pre-assessment, what we should do in our lesson planning for pre-assessment, we think about these things. What are the characteristics of the learners in the class? What do the students already know and understand? How do my students learn best? What modifications in instruction might I need to make? In warm-up and introduction, we should follow these things. Grab the attention of the students, provide the interest, motivation factor, set the tone for the lesson connected to the objective. That is a question, a story, a saying, an activity, a discussion starter. Be creative. What is the procedures and presentation of our lesson? Is it that set up a step-by-step plan, provide a quick review of previous learning, provide specific activities to assist students in developing the new knowledge. Provide modeling of a new skill. A picture is worth a thousand words. It means if we have teaching aids in our hands, we can explain the lesson with those things very effectively. And last one, I do, we do, you do. We can motivate our students with the saying that I do, we do, and you also can do it. Now, what is practice? Applying what is learned. It means what we have taught in our class, then it is very important to apply. Provide multiple learning activities. For this, we provide multiple learning activities for our students. Guided practice, teacher controlled, use a variety of questioning strategies to determine the level of understanding, journalism, conferencing, independent practice. Practice may be differentiated, build on success. Now, what are the learning activities which we can do in our classes? That is graphic organizers, creative play, peer presenting, performances, role playing, debates, game making, projects, cooperative groups, inquiry learning, direct instructions, differentiations, direct instructions. These are the learning activities we should impart in our class. And last step is closer. In closer, lesson wrap up, leave students with an imprint of what the lesson covered. It means we should give questions to the students that what you have learned from all these lessons. Students summarize the major concepts, display internalized students' knowledge. Teacher recaps the main points. Teacher sets the stage for the next phase of learning. lastly, we should do evolution. And in this step, we access the learner rubrics, teacher made test, in class or homework assignments, project to apply the learning in real life situations, recitations and summaries, performance assessments, use of rubrics, portfolios, journals, informal assessment. These are steps we can follow in our evaluation process. We should also set goals of students, and in these we should follow the following points. Goal are the all about high expectations. Keys to great goal settings are regular routine, mini goals, focus or small, immediate, action oriented. It means when we are setting our goals for students, they are also action oriented. Very specific actions, what, when, how. Level appropriate, it means goals are appropriate to the level of students. Followed by the reflections, students need to evaluate, leads to feeling of accomplishment and future goal setting. Now, what are the reflections of our lesson plan? What went well in the lesson? After delivering the lesson, we can think about on these points that are called reflections. What well went in the lesson? What problems did I experience? It means when I delivered my lesson, what are the problems did I experience? Are there things I could have done differently? How can I build on this lesson to make future lesson successful? Getting best out of lesson plan. After delivering our lesson, we can think on this point that getting best out of lesson plans. Think of a time when you enter a classroom without any plans. How do you feel? How would you like to feel if you need to run to make photocopies in the middle of the class? Let's now look at the 6 factors to make a best lesson plans. These are the main factors which we have to keep in our mind when we make a lesson plan. First one is ensure alignments across grades. Lesson planning should be done across grades to avoid omissions and unnecessary repetitions. If students have not been taught addition and subtraction from 20 to 100 in grade 1, they are not ready for addition and subtraction in the hundreds in grade 2. If students have been taught multiplication for 6th, 7th, 8th and 9th in grade 3, teachers should not be repeating the same multiplication table in grade 4. There is a difference between revision after the summer break and spending weeks on the topic as though the students have not done this before. Yet, quite often, we see either omission or overlaps across grades. The end of the semester is the best time to have grades meetings to discuss what has been accomplished and what needs to be worked on. If students are struggling this year, the teacher needs to inform the teacher teaching the next grade of the gap. Discuss strategies for filling the gaps and ways to avoid them in the future. Second one is avoid teaching from cover to cover. While this might work for some cases, I find that some textbooks in the US usually include a lot more materials than is required. When it provides teachers with option, it can be confusing for some teachers when they need to decide on what to teach. Teacher teaching from textbook cover to cover sometimes find that they are able to accomplish their goals and need to rush through the last few topics. A lesson plan is important as it gives a sense of direction in relation to standards. Teachers know what is important and what is secondary. It is more important for the students to learn deeply with the understanding than to skim through many topics superficially. Third one is how to teach. While being clear about what topics to teach is important, knowing how to teach them is the key to success in the classroom. With the students in mind, the teacher should ask questions like, should we spend more time on concentrated manipulatives, use more worksheet for practice, or even would printing worksheet in color versus black and white make a difference? Fourth one is, a good lesson plan makes a confidence teacher. Many teachers teach the way they are taught as students, however, that might not be the best way. We need to constantly update ourselves with best practices that work and how to teach more effectively. For example, a teacher who has only learned how to and not to why when growing up will need to evaluate their own gap in knowledge when drawing out the lesson plans for the semester. This gives the teacher confidence when delivering the lesson in the classroom. A confidence teacher inspires respect for the students, which in turn reduces disciplines and problems. Fifth one is, lesson planning now saves time in future. Lesson plan serves as a useful basis for future planning. They can be used again in part or in whole for future classes. Lesson planning for subsequent years can be drawn from and modified from current planning. The extra efforts put in by first year teachers to plan and organize the entire year lesson plan and resources will go a long way for substitute years teaching the same level. And the last one is handing over the professional performance. A clear lesson plan can be used by substitute teacher, ensuring that the time is used productively. When the main teacher is not around, it can also serve as a central document for handing over to the new teacher who are teaching the level for the first time. In addition, lesson plan along with the other materials can also be used to support annual performance evaluation. Teachers applying for a new job can also submit samples of their lesson plan to show their content, understanding, and organizational skill. In last, we should conclude with, there are many important benefits of having a clear and organized lesson plan. Good planning allows for more effective teaching and learning. However, many things can happen in class, and it is important for teachers to adopt their plans to respond to the students' need. We can end with our topic. It's by saying, James Clear says, prepare thoroughly, but in class, teach the learner, not the plan. So learner, we will meet you in our next lecture. Till then, thank you.